Shalom, Kahloi, Yahweh, Ba'ashem, Yahushai, Ba'ashem, Makar Kodash. And I want to give double honor to the Apostle Gwent Millstone and the elders will well. Peace and blessings to the elect, and salutation and honor to all you Akim out there that are laboring and that are doing the work in faithful and in truth. My name is Michael Allah, and this brother is
Karab,
and we're from the Boston camp. And the title of this lesson will be, The Lord Will Not Hear Your Cry in Times of Trouble. And as he says in Jeremiah 7:16, and he says, therefore pray not thou for these people, neither lift up cry nor prayer for them, neither make intercession to me, for I will not hear thee. And why is that? Because Israel are being rebellious. Since way back then, in the times when Jeremiah was in the scene, warning the people about the judgment that the Lord is about to bring upon them if they don't repent. What did they do? They chose to ignore Jeremiah and mistreated Jeremiah. Mm-hmm. So therefore, when that time do come, the Lord passed a swift judgment upon Israel by sending those other nations to attack Israel. Because they refused to turn from their wicked way. Likewise, it is the same thing that is happening to this very day in this era that we're living. We got a lot of Israelite men that's out there. They pass by us, but they don't bother to listen. Most of them don't bother to listen or ask questions. Mm-hmm. You know, but the world has already been noise abroad, so there is no excuse.
That's right.
You know, when that day do come. You can't say that, oh, I wasn't there, I wasn't around, I didn't hear the word. You can't make any excuse because it's everywhere. The word of the Lord is in all social media, mm-hmm. Instagram, TikTok. You know, Facebook, it's YouTube, it's being spread everywhere. So there is no excuse you could come out with saying that I did not hear the word of the Lord.
Right.
Go ahead.
Quick precept. This is Hosea 4:6.
Mm-hmm.
My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. Because thou hast rejected knowledge, I will also reject thee, that thou shalt be no priest to me. Seeing thou hast forgotten the law of thy power, I will also forget thy children.
Khan, one more time, Oxalaki.
Khan, this is Hosea 4:6. My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. Because thou hast rejected knowledge, I will also reject thee, that thou shalt be no priest to me.
Now, holy white day, he said that the people have rejected the Lord, you know, because of a lack of knowledge, because they have no wisdom of the word of Yahweh Bashem Yahushai. You know, but the Lord have already chosen certain men to be out there to bring them that knowledge. Mm-hmm. You know, so that way they can have an understanding of what's going on, and to know who they are or where they come from. But since they rejected that knowledge that we are giving to them to the spirit of Yahweh Bashem Yahushai, therefore the Lord is going to reject them.
Right.
For not receiving that knowledge. Because when you reject us, it's not us you're rejecting. You are rejecting Yahweh Bashem Yahushai. Because in the great spirit that we're in right now, the Lord is now knocking at your door, calling out to you while there's still yet time. So you better open up the door and let Yahushai in before it's too late. Go ahead, Art.
It says, seeing thou hast forgotten the law of thy power, I will also forget thy children. I'm going to continue on.
Mm-hmm.
Verse 7, as they were increased, so they sinned against me. Therefore will I change their glory into shame.
Mm. All right. Go, you could take that. You could break that down.
You see? So it says, they was increased, they sinned against the Lord. And that's what Jake's doing now. All right. Jake think because they have some money, you know, Jake think because they prosper in Esau's wicked kingdom. You know, what they're doing is they're walking further and further away from Yahweh Bashem Yahushua. That's why he said he's going to turn their glory into shame, which just happened in the ancient time.
Mm-hmm.
But now in this time, people look at the possessions that they have. People mm-hmm. look at the things that the substances that they have, and they think it's a thing of glory. But guess what? The Lord's going to strip them from that.
Con.
I'm going to continue on. This is verse 9. It says, and there shall be like people, like priests, and I will punish them for their ways and reward them their doings. You see? So the Lord is going to definitely judge them according to their doings. All right? You don't want to take heed. You don't want to listen to the words of Yahweh Bashem Yahushua through his prophets, through his men that he has set up on the highways and the byways. Guess what? You're basically putting yourself in the snare, man. All right? You're doing it to yourself because this is the ultimate way of receiving salvation. There's no other way. The scripture says, receive with meekness the engrafted word which is able to save your soul.
Come.
So if you don't receive the engrafted word which is able to save your soul, guess what? You're choosing death by default.
Come on. And that, like the brother said, man, if you don't choose the word of Yahweh Shai, you are choosing death by default. Mm-hmm. You know, I would have choose salvation, mm-hmm. than choose death. You know, because of course, a lot of you just saying that, if we die, we get reincarnated. Because you got nigga that would think like that.
Yeah.
You know, because they know that, you know, there's no such thing as hell. They're like, okay, let's just do our wickedness, and then we get reincarnated in the kingdom. But believe me, man, when I say this, you're going to regret ever saying these words. Mm-hmm. Because as the Lord said this, as it says in the scripture, it is a fearful thing to fall at the hand of the living power. Mm-hmm. And the most I could prolong your suffering. You do not want to test the Heavenly Father by saying that.
That's right.
Trust me, you don't. You know? And it says in, if you got another precept to bring out.
Nah, go ahead, get yours.
And this is on Proverbs chapter 1. Verse 20, and he says, wisdom cried for fault, she uttered her voice in the street, which is exactly what we're doing right now. You know, she cries in the chief place of concourse, in the opening of the gate in the city, she uttered her word, saying, how long, ye simple one, will ye love simplicity, mm-hmm. and a scorner delight in their scorning, and fool hate knowledge. Mm-hmm. And you niggas hate knowledge.
Right.
You hate the word of Yahweh Shai. You know, you want to choose the wisdom, the knowledge of this world, which is foolishness to the Heavenly Father, then choose the wisdom and the knowledge that Yahweh Shai has given to you, which will able to help you to obtain salvation, you know, and to see things that others cannot see. And he says, turn ye up my reproof, behold, I will pour out my spirit unto you, I will make you know my word unto you. And that's how the Lord have done for me and this brother right there, Akim, and all the other brother that are now in the truth. The Lord have opened up our eyes to see the truth, you know?
That's right.
The Lord have shown mercy on us by opening up our eyes and make his word known unto us. Now we have seen it, and now we believe in the word of Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai. And that's his mercy he has shown upon us. And I said, Tawadah Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai, you know, for opening up my eyes to the truth. You know, for allowing me to see the things that others cannot see, that others wish to see.
Come on, can I bring a quick precept real quick?
Come on,
this is Proverbs 4:18, just to back what you just said. It says, but the path of the just is as a shining light that shineth more and more unto the perfect day. The way of the wicked is as darkness, and they know not at what they stumble. All right. Once again, going into, if you receive this truth, it says the path of the just is as a shining light, and that light increases more and more into the coming day of our Lord Yahweh Shem El Shah. But guess what? It, for the wicked, it's darkness. All right. And guess what? You know, there's no light in them. They don't choose to walk towards the light. They don't choose to walk in the light. They don't anything that has to do with light. They want to do the complete opposite, which is to be in darkness, to sin, to be wicked. Mm-hmm. All right, to reject the words of Yahweh Shem El Shah, and ultimately the rejection is what's going to get them destroyed.
Gone. You know, and that's why, and that's why now, you know, in the time that we're living in right now, and of course we are living in darkness right now. Mm-hmm. As you see, all prophecy is being fulfilled. You know, you see all prophecy is coming to pass. Just look what's happening in your daily news. Every day something new come out, and it's not good.
I got one more. Just to back that up, you can jump back. This
Go
is
ahead.
John 3,
mm-hmm.
and verse. Salakia.
Check your time.
This is John 3. John 3:19. It says, and this is the condemnation that light is come into the world,
mm-hmm.
and men love darkness rather than light because their deeds were evil.
You see? Men love darkness rather than light because the deed are evil.
Mm-hmm.
And that is how it is today in this time, in this era. Men love darkness.
Mm-hmm.
Why? Because Esau, the so-called white man, is in control. He's in power. Ever since he got the fatness of the earth, he have turned the whole world upside down,
right.
and deceived the whole entire world. You know. But to the spirit of Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai, the Lord have chosen prophet men to go out there to awaken those that are in the darkness and to bring them back into the light.
That's right. Come on, we'll continue on. Verse 20 says, for everyone that doeth evil hateth the light, neither cometh to the light, these his deeds shall be reproved. But he that doeth truth cometh to the light, and his deeds may be made manifest that they are wrought in the Most High.
You can break that down.
You see?
Mm-hmm.
So it says, everyone that doeth evil hateth the light. All right, and who is the light? Yahweh Shah. Yahweh Shah came into the world to push this truth, to get us back on the right path, so we may inherit the kingdom of heaven. All right, but guess what? They want to do wickedness. They want to be involved in folly and bullshit, right? But it says, he that doeth truth cometh to the light. All right. And that's going into those that receive the words. Receive your Yahweh Bashi Mount Shah. Mm-hmm. All right, you're coming to the light. This is, like you said, this is an opportunity for you to gain salvation, man. Receive mercy. Mm-hmm. All right, which receiving this truth is one of the highest forms of mercy that we can get on this side, because we ultimately know what's coming, the time of Jacob's trouble. Mm-hmm. All right, and that's a time that, you know, like the scripture says, that's going to be like never before. So everyone's going to be in a dire situation, but the only people that the Lord is going to hear and hearken unto is who? Those that dwell in truth, those that dwell in the light, those that call upon His name.
Khan. Mm-hmm.
Go ahead.
Yeah, it is. They're the one that have. They have a more of a chance of making it than those that are in the darkness, than those that are not in the truth and stay on the left hand side. But for those men, you know, who kept the faith. And endure until the end, they're the one whom the Lord is going to preserve to make it, you know, out of that darkness and into salvation. Mm-hmm. You know, and that's why the great spirit that we have right now, you know, we're supposed to use it while there's still time left. Use that great spirit while there's still time left, because the time's gonna come where when you see all these things that the brother have been telling you in the street come to pass, you may not get that second chance to make it. Because you're gonna be on your knees crying to for the Heavenly Father to come and save you, you know. But what? How's the Lord gonna answer you? What the Lord's gonna say on that day when He see you on your knees begging for help? Well, we'll see. It says in Proverbs chapter 1, verse 24, and He says, "But because I have called and ye refuse, I have stretched out my hand and no man regarded." You know. And who's calling out to you, Jake, right now? It is the Heavenly Father, Yahweh Bashim, Yahweh Shai.
That's right.
You know, His Son that died on the cross for us so that we may have salvation. He's the one that's calling out to you, Jake. Mm-hmm. Because He knows how bad things is gonna get here in America. Not just here in America, but throughout all the world. Because some of you niggas think that you could just escape in America and go to a different
country
and think that you're gonna be saved there. Nope. Wherever you go, judgment will follow.
That's right.
Judgment will follow. You could be in the UK, you're going to catch 10 times more hell, just as much as you're going to catch it here in America. Mm-hmm. The only difference is America's going to get blown out completely by that thermonuclear destruction that's going to come here.
That's right.
You know? But when tribulation come, man, everybody is going to go through it. And if the Lord is not with you on that day, man, then your life is hopeless. You ain't get no chance of ever making out of there. Right. And He says right here, but you have set at naught all my counsel, and would not of my reproof. A lot of things that Jake like to do is they like to seek the counsel of their pastors who don't have no truth.
Yep.
They like to seek counsel with Buddhists, you know, who have no truth. You know, and they'll go to Esau, the so-called white man, who's only out there seeking to destroy them.
That's right.
They'll seek counsel from everybody else but Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. You know?
That's why it says, yeah. That's what it says in Isaiah the 30th chapter.
Mm-hmm.
All right. It talks about woe unto them that go down to Egypt.
In fact, you go get that if you cannot.
Come on, this is Isaiah 30 and 1. It says, "Woe to the rebellious children that say to the Lord, that take counsel, but not of me, that take a cover. That cover, so like in that cover with a covering, but not of my spirit, that they may add sin to sin, that walk to go down into Egypt, and have not asked at my mouth to strengthen themselves in the strength of Pharaoh, and to trust in the shadow of Egypt. Therefore shall the strength of Pharaoh be your shame, and the trust in the shadow of Egypt your confusion." All right, so that's the thing. A lot of people is running to Esau Edom, not knowing that Esau Edom is the one that's seeking to destroy them. All right, that's what the Lord said. What, John 10:10, the thief cometh not but to steal, kill, and destroy.
Yep.
But the Lord Yahweh Shah came to do what? He come to bring everlasting life and life more abundantly.
Yep.
All right, this is what Yahweh Bashim Shah is, where life is. And that's what when you read Psalms 91, it goes out and lays, he that abides in the shadow, in the secret place of the Most High, shall abide in the shadows of the Almighty. That's that protection plan, all right, of Yahweh Bashim Shah. All right, but see, Jake, they so hard-headed, they so stubborn, they so stiff-necked that they don't even want to inquire what to do in that time, or how can I be able to escape these times, man. They don't inquire, because guess what? They want to just go back to everything being normal, going to the club. You know what I'm saying? They want to just do the same old bullshit that they was once doing, knowing that we're heading on a route to on a decline, man. America's going down. They don't see that Babylon is falling, man. All right?
Exactly. And they're so lost by the entertainment of this world, by the thing that Esau presented before them. And of course, them being in their youth, they think that, okay, I have plenty of time to seek out the Most High. So let me just do whatever I want to do. You know, really thinking that in their mind that they could just, you know, do whatever the hell they want and then choose to follow the Lord when the time is right. It's not going to go that way, man. It's not going to go your way, you know. Because he said in the scripture, that the Lord should come as a thief in the night, mm-hmm. when you least expect it. That's why it is the time to seek out Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai 10 times more while the evil days come not.
That's right.
You know, but if you choose not to do so and you got caught up unaware, you know, and that's the time you're gonna be calling out the Lord, that's the time you're gonna be on your knees begging the Heavenly Father come and save you. He's not gonna save you in the time of your trouble.
It goes into it in Proverbs the first chapter, as you was reading. If you continue reading, it goes into what he's gonna be doing to those that rejected his word.
In fact, let me go back to the Proverbs chapter 1, verse 26, and continue on. And he says, I also will laugh at your calamity, I will mock when your fear cometh. When your fear cometh as desolation, and your destruction cometh as a whirlwind, when distress and anguish come upon you, then shall they call upon me, but I will not answer. They shall seek me early, but they shall not find me. And that's what's gonna happen, man. Mm-hmm. That's what's gonna happen to a lot of you jicks out there. And the times of your trouble, and the time of your calamity, you know, when you see the evil coming right at your door, you're gonna be begging, crying. You know, crying with all your being, seeking out the Heavenly Father, mm-hmm. to come and deliver you in a time of your distress. You know, because Esau, believe me, man, Esau is getting ready to make his move.
That's right.
Esau is getting ready to make his move because I was watching from TikTok, you know, where I think it was in Canada, where this Edomite talking about the Maxine. Where he's saying that there are more people who's not taking a vaccine. Now we got to do it another way, because he's saying that less and less people are taking a vaccine, and there's not enough people that's taking it. So what he's planning to do is he's planning to send troop men into your house to get you to take the vaccine. It's gonna happen, man. It's gonna come to a point in time where Esau just gonna use force.
That's right.
upon you jicks, man. Upon you wicked niggas out there, man, who refuse to listen to the word.
Right.
Don't waste that great spirit that the Lord is giving to you right now. Because you're not going to get it. You may not get another chance when that time do arrive. And he says, then they shall call upon me, then shall they call upon me, but I will not answer. They shall seek me early, but they shall not find me, for that they hated knowledge and did not choose the fear of the Lord. And that's why you nigga doing whatever the hell you want to do, because you're not afraid of the Heavenly Father.
That's right.
You know? Seeing as the evil they have not overcome you yet, you think that the Father fall asleep, so you continue as you were, doing the wicked things on this earth. You know, doing wicked abomination act that's provoking the Heavenly Father to wrath, not knowing that the Most High have your number. Mm-hmm. And when the Most High gets you, he will get you in the most horrible way, man.
That's right.
You know, like, again, as I said in the scripture, it is a fearful thing to fall at the hand of the living power. You know, you know them TV show, man. You know what them TV show called A Thousand Ways to Die? The Most High have a million ways upon you to death.
Infinite.
He's infinite, man. Slowly and painful. Mm-hmm. Death by pain, as it said in the scripture. And you don't want that. Trust me, you do not want that. And he said, there will none of my approves, they despise all my approve. And that's why a lot of you niggas are going to be put to death on that day. Because you choose to ignore the word of Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai and continue doing things that displeases the Lord. You're about to tell you, man, the time is going to come where you, Jake, are about to see what's about to happen. Just like you be watching all the apocalyptic movie and you see all the evil that's happening in this movie, the turmoil, the destruction, you about to see all that come into reality. And when it does come, it's going to be much more worse than them horror movies that you just be watching, you know, in your house and at the theater. You're about to see, man. It's no joke, though. The Heavenly Father, Yahweh Shammashai, ain't playing around no more. He's not playing around, and he's getting ready to bring a heavy judgment upon the earth. And if you niggas don't repent, you know, and turn away from your wickedness, the Most High will destroy you.
I got a quick precept if you ain't finished.
Go, I'm all set. Coming out.
Judges 10, I'm going to start at verse 10. And the children of Israel cried unto the Lord, saying, we have sinned against thee.
Oh, we do one time out?
This is Judges 10 and 10. And the children of Israel cried unto the Lord, saying, we have sinned against thee, both because we have forsaken our power and also served Balaam. It says, and the Lord said unto the children of Israel, did I not deliver you from the Egyptian and from the Amorites, from the children of Ammon and from the Philistines, the Zidonians also, and the Amalekites and the Maonites, Maonites did oppress you, and you cried to me, and I deliver you out of their hands, yet ye have forsaken me and served other gods. Wherefore I will deliver you no more. Go and cry unto the gods which ye have chosen. Let them deliver you in a time of your tribulation. You see? The Most High saying what? To go call upon them gods. So those that want to go out there for Easter Sunday, you know, go to the church, call upon
White Jesus,
yep. You know, and all these other gods, them Kemet guys calling the Egyptian gods.
Yep. Buddhism.
Hey, man, the Most High's not playing. He said, go call upon them and see if they're going to deliver you.
which they're not.
They're not.
They're not going to deliver Jake in time of trouble. And they're going to realize that, too. They're going to realize that, you know, that all these things that were given to them were false.
That's right.
Yeah, they're going to realize that there was only one true power.
That's right.
You know, and they have chosen to ignore that one true power, which is Yahweh Bar Shabbat Shai. Right. And they're going to regret it in those days, man. You Jake are going to regret it, you know.
I got another one.
We'll end it with that one. All right.
This is 2 Ezra 9, and I'm going to start at verse 7. It says, and everyone that shall be saved and shall be able to escape by his works and by faith whereby you have believed shall be preserved from the said perils and shall see my salvation in my land and within my borders, for I have sanctified them for me from the beginning. Then shall they be in pitiful case which have abused my ways, and they that have cast them away despitefully shall dwell in torment. For such as in their life have received benefits and have not known me, and they that have loathed my law while they had yet liberty, and when that place of repentance was opened unto them, understood not, but despised it, the same must know it after death by pain.
You see? Mm-hmm. You see, you're going to have those men whom the Lord are going to preserve, which are the elect men of the nation of Israel, those men the Lord are going to preserve to from not being put in the condition to be tortured and destroyed, to die starvation. Those are the men whom the Lord is going to preserve, and he's going to guide them where they need to go to escape all that calamity. But as for the rest of you niggas out there who are of the two-thirds, you know, you all are going to go through it, you know? You all gonna go through it, man, and you're gonna fall into a lot, and whatever the Lord's gonna have prepared for you is gonna be to your destruction.
Right.
It's gonna be to your destruction, whether it be by the famine, the waste war, you know, or in the FEMA camp where you get tortured to death. The Lord have many ways, man, to put you Jake to death. You know. He has many ways to put you Jake to death, man. And I'm telling you, man, a lot of you niggas, like I said, are going to regret not listening to the word of Yahweh Bar Shem Yahushai. So with that, I'm going to say, Kol Haloi, Yahweh Bar Shem Yahushai, Bar Shem with Kol Kodash. And I want to give double honor to the Apostle Great Millstone and the elders who were well. Peace and blessing to the elect man, and salutation and honor to all you Akim out there that are laboring and that are doing the work in faithful and in truth. So with that, I'm going to say Shalom.
Shalom.